Hey, this is Fishy. Welcome to my second commentated IL-2 video. Be sure to check the description for bookmarks, they allow you to skip the boring parts. As in every mission, I ordered my wingman to start his engines first. Then I started up my own engines. I dimmed down the reticle brightness, I was sure I wouldn't need that for a while. Then I began to taxi to takeoff. Taxiing isn't too difficult, you just need to be careful. While it isn't difficult, you can still fail at everything. I saved a replay for this mission, which enables me to show off some exterior views, although I played the mission on the realistic setting. The replay feature is bugged though, later in the mission it doesn't show what happened exactly, but I can still show you some of the material from the beginning. By the way, when I record IL-2, I am watching something alongside. This time I watched a lecture about the bombing of Germany. You can find a link in the description. I stopped in order to wait for number one to take off first. My flaps were lowered to take off and my tail wheel was locked. I set full throttle and proceeded to gather up speed. At about 200 km per hour, I gently pulled up. After takeoff, I raised my gear and my flaps, as usual. Nothing special here, really. Now the climb began. I only had to follow the leader and gain altitude, no hard tasks at hand. So, what kind of plane was I flying and why? I was in the mood to shoot up bombers, but I didn't want to build a whole new mission. So I took the Black Thursday mission and changed it a bit to have the player in a different plane than last time. I was thinking about the FW-190, which I discarded quickly. I mean, I already made a video of the mission in A-190. I also thought about the BF-109, but I discarded that one too. There is a video of roughly the same thing too. The ME-210 and the ME-410 came to my mind, but I would need to install mods in order to fly those. Mods always limit your performance, and there are about 120 B-17s in this mission. I need the best performance possible. So, what else can you fly in vanilla IL-2? Most of you have guessed it already, I think. But for those of you who don't know what plane this is, it's a BF-110 G2, of course. I tried the mission earlier in the 110 with default loadout, but that didn't go very well. I ran out of ammo after my third kill and I didn't deem that good enough. I took a shower and I was thinking to myself, what if I stick a whole lot of guns on the 110? Its high altitude performance is already poor and it certainly wouldn't help to stick a whole lot of stuff on it. But I had an idea. I went on and put two MK-108s and four 21 cm rocket launchers on it, but I also reduced the fuel capacity to 50% in order to save weight. So altogether my plane was armed with two 7.92 machine guns for the rear gunner, two 20 mm cannons, which need about 20 hits to down one bomber, two 30 mm cannons, which only need about 3 hits to down a plane, to pretty much down any plane, and four 21 cm rockets, which are very potent if you can hit them. To take a whole lot of armament but less fuel worked out great, as you will see later. At about 10:40 a.m. in-game time, the enemy formation came into view. At the time I was at about 5,900 meters, which isn't high enough. I tried to pull as hard as reasonable, but it wasn't enough. So I passed below the bombers, getting shot at without being able to do anything about it. At the time I reached the second combat wing, I thought I had gathered enough altitude, but I hadn't. I really shouldn't have taken that shot. Pretty bad beginning. I turned around to set up a rocket attack. The 110 isn't much faster than a AB-17 with all the weight and drag added, but I constantly came closer. I noticed the upper squadron was nearer, but I wanted to put my rockets between those two, which were very close together. after my rockets exploded, I could immediately see that I caused some trouble. One B-17 began to smoke, one had a huge hole in its fuel tank, and one more jettisoned its bombs. After a few seconds, the smoking B-17's condition worsened. By then, there was black smoke coming from its wing, which indicated a secured kill. There is no way to fix such a fuel tank fire, the bomber will lose its wing sooner or later. While I was overtaking the rear combat wing, I noticed a damaged B-17, which was dropping out of formation. I know you don't like rear attacks, but I still made the decision to go for it. I fired two short bursts into the fuselage and into the left wing. The fortress became uncontrollable and began to spin towards the ground. I was thinking about a sideways attack on the first combat wing, but I decided to overtake it and attack from the front. I began to turn to the left in order to set up a frontal attack. Fuel tank fire, that's a kill. Pull up, set up a second attack. I switched to the rear gunner's view and could see the 17 already lost its wing. I shot blind and ripped a wing off. Two attacks and two kills. It can go on like that. Please ignore the crashing AI. I really try to make them not crash, but it seems to be impossible. The high combat box already took a lot of casualties. I made the decision to go for another rear attack. After several ranging shots, I finally scored some hits, bringing the bomber down. I only need to see the black smoke from the rear gunner's position to be sure. I gained enough lead on the bombers, time to turn in. That one jettisoned its bombs, but I think only the left outboard engine took damage. That's not enough to bring one down. Proceed to attack another one. Fuel tank fire again, another kill. As I came out of my turn, I immediately noticed some damaged bombers and decided to attack one of them from the rear. I just checked my fuel gauge. Remember, I took off with only 50% and I only have 300 liters left. Going full throttle, which I am doing all the time, simply burns a lot of fuel. I was thinking about leaving that one alone. You know how it is, don't want to push your luck. I still went for it, though. One slightly longer burst was enough to rip off a wing. While I still had ammo left, I decided to head home.
Thank you.
While I had the beacon BD selected, I noticed that I was flying away from it. At 47 minutes and 20 seconds mission time, I made the decision to turn around and head for the base at AZ-23 instead of my home base. At 49:21 I noticed a characteristic meander. That river was clearly the one I saw on the map. From that point on, I only had to follow the beacon and land safely. At about 58:30, I was sure the airport was right in front of me. At about 59, I began my approach. At 1 hour and 49 seconds I touched the ground again. At 1 hour, 1 minute and 40 seconds, I shut off my engines, ended the mission and checked the results. I made it, 8 kills, with 100 liters left in the tank. Pretty nice mission. Thank you guys for watching.